Best of luck.
Thank you, Emma. And to explain more, we have a legend in the studio, Mr. Coronation Street himself. He's been there right from the start. And I suppose, William Roache, lovely to see you. We've got the Duchess of Cornwall to thank for what we've got here in this little bit that Ruth's got to...
I love this.
Exhibit
okay.
here.
Yep. Yeah.
So how did that come about?
Tell us about
well,
the Roache.
Well, to celebrate the 50th...
Or you could have them that way.
Can you get the birds? Celebrate the 50th anniversary.
They're
flying. These were on Hilda's wall, these ducks, of course. That's
yes,
why they're famous.
It was made by a Manchester jeweller called Keith Simpson. It was bespoke made for the day because the Duchess of Cornwall was visiting us and... they presented her with that brooch, and she wore it during the day, and then she very kindly, at the end of it, gave it back to raise money for our 50th anniversary charity, which is for the NSPCC, Cancer Research UK and Christie's. So it's got things on the back about commemorating the situation. The Duchess was wonderful. She was so kind.
And you friendly. You got to show
I was the first to meet her on the cobbles. And, yeah, there we go. And apart from being kind and friendly and warm, she was actually very knowledgeable also about the street, which was very exciting. She pulled a pint, as you see, in the Rovers.
I agree. She was very friendly. I met her. I found her very, very likable.
She's lovely.
And she's very funny, isn't she?
Yeah, she's very funny.
Very humorous, I agree with you. Yeah.
Very warm, very friendly. Friendly and really a charming person, so she can come to the Rovers anytime she wants. Free invitation. Okay.
And did the cast decide the charities you were going to?
The cast, they had a vote at the beginning of the year because to celebrate the 50th anniversary, they decided they would have a cast charity. So we all cast votes, and the top ones that came out were the NSPCC, Cancer UK, and Christie's.
Yeah. Well, the anniversary. What an anniversary! We know so much about it, and nobody really knows more about it than you. Let's have a look.
I should be going out later on.
Are you meeting a girl?
Yes.
I would go out tonight, but I haven't got the stitch to wear.
Look, I'm just looking for my shirt. It's you that's making all the noise about it.
It's charming now.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir?
You don't want to get lumbered with me.
I pronounce them to be man and wife together.
That was our best attempt in a couple of minutes to put together your history and coronation. Was there a golden period for you? Was there a time when you look back at the 50 years and you say, do you know, that for me was my time or the best?
Well, it's now.
Exactly. It's very much a case of the here and now. And I must say, last year, the 50th anniversary of the tram crash, the live episode, was as probably as memorable as anything we've ever done. Because when we started, there's no such thing as soap. I really don't like the word soap. Mm-hmm. We were cutting-edge, realistic drama featured on television. And those looked like a totally different era, different period. The schedule was different. Everything with scenes were longer. And now we film from, 8 in the morning till 7 at night. Can be 6 days a week, and it's much turnover. But it is a question of here and now, and I'm loving it now. And last year, I must say, Phil Collinson, the producer, he came up with all those things, the special effects of the tram crash. Yes. The live episode, I hope we don't do another one. They really frightened. Oh. Absolutely
really?
Terrifying. You know, 15 million people are watching and they say, right, 22nd studio.
Well, when you started off, did you not do a lot of it live? Was there not?
Well, we started. We used to get our Monday and Friday. We'd do the first one live and then record the other.
Yeah.
But in those days, there was a lot of live television and that only happened for about 3 months and then a strike knocked it out of sync and we didn't do it.
And do you think was it good for you all to do the live episode? Does it give you that
extra don't say bit that. No. But what it did do, it brought a whole lot of people in. It hadn't been watching for a while, and then they get curious about all the stories that emanate. It's not like a big crash and then there's an anticlimax. It created a whole lot of stories. So we've held on to a whole lot of new viewers who came in. Yeah. It's a very exciting time, and you know, we might be 50 years old, but there's still a lot of life.
Well, we're thinking of doing this live, aren't we, one day?
Oh, yeah.
We're building up,
we're a bit nervous about it.
Do you know, I am the same age as Coronation Street.
You're not.
33?
It's worn better than me, it has
well,
to be
no,
said.
No, you look very young. Very young.
You hold the record now for being
I'm in the Guinness Book of Records.
Longest serving.
actor
in a
not
serial
a soap,
drama.
In an ongoing drama. Yes, that's right, in the world, yeah.
But you're still right in the thick of the storylines of the tram crash with your son, Peter. It's
lovely to have my two sons, Linus and James, in it. And James is coming back in, starting filming in March. Mm-hmm. And Linus could only... He lives in America and he was in Law and Order. He could only get 2 weeks, so the story was very quick and over.
But that was good. He obviously did that as a tribute to his dad. I mean,
it's very kind of you to say so, but
the money.
Probably, I'm sure it was. he was homophobic in it, and we need to bring him back to explain why. Young James is on now, is coming in again in March for 2 months with the two young lesbian girls, so there should be an interesting story there.
But just quickly, in that 50 years, there must have been times whether you wanted to go or they wanted to get rid of you, were there or not?
Well, I don't know, but there was a phase, after about 3 years, the BBC used to, if they had a serial that was successful, they'd take it off after 3 years. And after about 3 years of The Street, they brought a producer in who decided to get rid of all the old cast and bring in a new cast. So there was like a time on everybody, and I think I was in that. But they very quickly realised that was wrong, and she went, so we carried on. In the middle, there was a sort of sag when Ken ceased to be the young Jew and wasn't quite getting all the girlfriends he had that I wondered about moving on. But
well, we're very glad you didn't.
I'm thrilled. I love it more than ever.
We could talk to you all day, but unfortunately, this is live.
And we've got to go.
That wasn't live, was it?
Rich Junior, I'm afraid it was.
All right.
Good luck with the competition and the appeal. We'll be back again next Friday. Good to see you.